Hi, in this video we'll see how to work with parameters, parameters by filters and parameters with sets. So parameters are nothing but dynamic values which you can change and you can interact with your chart itself, that's a bar graph. Let us see that. First of all, I'm working into a workbook named as parameters and sets. You can download the workbook from this below video itself. Next is, I'm working into a global superstore 2017. Now what I'll do is, I'll first create a bar graph and then I'll show you what exactly parameters means. So I'll pick up a sales subcategory and sales. So these are sales based on the subcategory part. Now what I want is, I want to filter this subcategory based on the top 10 sales which are done. So first of all, I'll sort this into the descending order. So these are somewhere around 10 subcategories which I want to sort out. So I'll pick up this subcategory and put into this filters. I'll get a dialog box. What I want is, I'll select this top by field. Click on top 10. So if you see top 10 elements which are based on sum of sales, select it and I'll click on apply. And if I click on OK, if you see there are 10 elements, 10 subcategories, click on OK. Right now, if I want to change from 10 to 20, or if I want to change from 10 to 7, 8 or any numbers, every time I have to modify it. Every time I have to click on this drop down, select edit filter, and I have to go to this top and I have to keep on changing the value. But sometimes if you have a dashboard where you want a user should be able to change it automatically, so you need to use the parameters. That is a user friendly, a user can also do. So you don't have to go into the settings and keep on do the changing part. How do I create a parameter is very simple. Select here as top 10, click on this drop down and you see this option is given as create a new parameter, and you have to give some name of the parameter. I'll give as top n. That's a parameter which should be created. And what is the current value you want? I'll say as the current value, let's say 10 it should be. The minimum number is given as 1 and the maximum I'll keep it as, let's say 10. That's a maximum number I want the user should be able to change. Click on OK and I'll click on apply. Okay, so if you observe the number of subcategories, these are 10 which are given here, but on the right hand side I'll get a parameter control which says this is nothing but top n, there are 10 elements. And this is a slider which I can just move it forward and backward. If I move it backward, you see the number is changing and the data will also change. If I take it on the back, you see there are a number of elements which are given as 5. So a user doesn't have to go to the settings and keep on changing the number of categories, the number of top elements you want. A user can simply just use the scroll bar and he can get the filtered data in short. So that is nothing but these are known as parameters with filters itself, right? So you can just keep on scrolling left or right anywhere. Now this is a slide bar in case if you want a user to enter some number, let's say 1, 2, 3, anything. So you can click on this drop down and select this option as type in. This is one more form of layout. Click on this type in and here I can click on this box and I can just type as 5 and enter. So I'll get those 5 elements. So you can allow a user to enter some number and based on that you can get the graph itself, right? So that is very simple method by using a parameter with the filters itself. Now let's see the second one. I have parameters with sets. This is not parameters with filters, but it is parameters with sets. First, let me draw a bar graph. So I'll pick up the subcategory, I'll pick up the sales and put it here. Now what I want is, I want to highlight the colors based on the top 10 elements, top 5 elements, anything. So two things I have to use. I'll have the parameters and second, I'll have the sets. First of all, I'll just filter out. So these are descending order which are given here. Now, if I want to filter the subcategories, or if I want to highlight the subcategories, I need to create a set first of all. So I'll click on this drop down and I'll click on this create subcategory pills if I have selected. Click on this create option and then I have to click on this set. So based on what elements do you want to create a set? Set is nothing but collection of few elements, if you can see the data which you have. Now I'll say I want to give the name as my set. I have given some name and I want to create a set based on the top by field. Top, do I want some number? I'll not have some number, but I'll have some parameter. Remember why I've taken the parameter? Because we are working on parameters with sets. So I'm creating a set based on this parameter. The name is given as top n and I'll click on OK. Okay, so what has happened is I've created named as my set and there's already a parameter which is top n. So first of all, I'll try to bring this top n here. I'll just click on this drop down and I'll say as show parameter control. So on the right hand side, I'll get a parameter control, which you're already aware. Now I'll pick up this my set and I'll put into the colors part. So if you observe here, there are some grayed out in this place. These are some which are again created a set. So what, why? Because they are creating a set, because here on the right hand side the number is given as 5. If I say 7, so set of 7 elements will be created and those will be colored into a blue color. So if I say I want to create set of 2 elements or 2 subcategories, so you see 2 subcategories have been selected based on what condition? Based on top sum of sales. So sum of sales of these 2 categories is the highest, so you're getting the category as a set itself. And again, if you want, you can just modify. I'll just make it as 9. And if you see, these are the 9 elements which have been created a set based on this parameter control. So I hope you're able to understand how do we work on the parameters using the filters and also with the sets. That's all for this video.